Hi everyone and welcome to Build the Terminator issue number one, pack one if you like. This is stage number two. Now this is the components for the head and right arm. So basically this is a very lovely shiny bit. It is very, very heavy. We've got a little bit of the lower jaw, which is going to be great because we're going to be acting like a dentist putting teeth in. And we've got your screws, you've got the upper jaw as I said, you've got the right arm component, which is a this part here. You've then got the right arm component B, which is that section. Right arm component C, which is this part. Where's it gone? It's that part there. It was the right part. What am I doing, Mike? We've got a pack of selection of screws, and then obviously 2-2 is the upper teeth. So the first thing it wants us to do is obviously, before you get started, make sure to carefully examine all the pieces, which we've just done. So obviously that looks okay. This looks all okay to me. To make sure of, and we're also making sure that they match what's in the description of the book. So yeah, that all looks pretty good. And obviously we've got the teeth and the screws here. So I'm going to move them over to one side. The first section that we're going to be doing is we're going to be bringing in this section that we did last time. Now what we're I'm going to be referring to this quite a lot, guys. So what we're going to be doing now is where we've got the two wires, what we're going to do is we're going to be securing the top of the jaw there and marrying that up into the facial features. So let's get this started. Okay, so obviously this is the bottom of the jaw, and as you can see, these have got the pin there and the two hole, and what will happen is this will slot and mimic that, so it will slot into there like so. We're then going to get the two longer screws, and as you can see, you've got a couple of long screws either side of here, so that's where they're going to go down. So we'll get the screw lined up as best we can. Pick it up. If it's going to pick up, it's not going to pick up for me. And basically you want it so that that goes into that hole, which could be a little bit difficult. However, I'm only using tweezers because my screwdriver is not magnetized, you see. Okay, so obviously I've used the tweezer just to get that lined up. I will get my magnetizer. Keep forgetting to get it as I film. And then obviously we'll screw them right the way down into the lower jaw. I feel like I'm a surgeon working on doing like jaw surgery. You know, putting like a screw in and holding it together with plates or something. So obviously we'll screw that into position. You don't need too much grip as I said, but obviously enough grip just to hold that in. Now obviously that holds that into position, and we're going to put the other one in now. This is with the 2.6mm screw. And as I said before, I'm going to use the tweezers just because my magnetizer is in the other room. So obviously I'm going to screw this down like so. And then obviously you can see that it screws down here, as you can see. If I just show you, it screws down there. Okay. So I'll screw this right the way down. Like that. Okay, so once we've screwed them down, that's holding that position into place. Now the next part, what we're going to do is we're now going to put the two of the PB2 4mm screws, which is the smaller version, and they're going to go into this little hole here and that hole there. Okay, so these are the 2.4s and they're going to go into that hole there. Normally I would offer the screwdriver to the screw, however it's not magnetized as I said, so we'll just screw that into position like so. Lovely. And then we'll pop the other 2.4 into there as well. which is over this side, like that. And as you can see, you can marry them, the screws up, that these are obviously, these are 6 mils, if I just move that there, and obviously these are 4 mils. Well, that's more 6, but you can see that's another 4 mil. So we'll just screw that into position. So obviously, as you can see, I'll just screw that into position like that. And that looks really good. Look at that. It looks really, really good. So obviously, as you can see, this is now the top of the jaw, which will mimic, obviously, this section that we've just done. That will be that part around there. Okay, so this is where the fun part starts, because this is where we start to do teeth work. So obviously, once you've got your screws, just make sure you don't lose them. I'm going to push them over to one side because I will finish that out in post-production. I've got to label them up anyway. So obviously, these are the teeth. Now, this is where the fun part starts, because this is where we've got to do some teeth work, some filing if need be. And all the teeth are numbered, so obviously if we look at it very carefully, you've got, which if you look on the other side, they're actually labelled here. There's a little symbol next to each one, and you've got 1, 2 at the top, and then 3 and 4. So basically they want us to cut these out as best we can. Now obviously what we need to do is we need to cut it as best to the edge as we can, like that. Now you may have a little bit of a rough edge, that's fine, because I will file that down in a minute. Might just give it a little bit of a snip, and then obviously we'll get the second one, which is this one here. Some people like to bend them off, but I like to cut them off because it gives it a, you know, a proper cut. Okay, and then what we'll do is we'll get another one. We'll cut 3 off. So obviously this is 1, 2. So obviously you've got 1, you've got 2 there. And then obviously we'll cut 3 off, which is this one here. And then obviously 4, which is this one here. Okay, so obviously 3 and 4. Now what will happen now is, obviously you won't need that anymore, but basically you may see that on some of the teeth there's like little rough edges. That's fine, because you may need to sand draw a little bit, you know, file it off a bit. Just to, I like to use the cuts if I can. Just go like that a little bit. So yeah, that's fine. And then obviously you've got your teeth there. Now, obviously, as I said, what we need to do now. Is we're gonna be attaching these into the top of the jaw. And this is where the holes of the jaw are. Now obviously, we're gonna be gluing these in. So obviously make sure that they fit in right, because once they're glued in, there's no coming out. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to get a cocktail stick. I'm going to get a little bit of this plastic. I'll get some glue. Just pop a dollop there. We'll get the cocktail stick. And basically we'll work our way into the hole here. So obviously the first one that we're going to put in is number 4. We'll put 4 and then work our way round to 1. Because I think that's probably going to be, 4. You could go 4 or 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, or 1, 2, 3, 4. It's up to you. I'm going to work 4 first, because I think that would be good. So obviously I'm just making sure that goes in. So obviously it is directional. And as you can see, once we put this in, it will fit in. And it will go a specific way, as you can see. So obviously, and then just to show you number 1, you can see that once that goes in
Right, so we'll pop that in around the right way again. So obviously that one fits in better to that one, so that must be 4. Okay, so obviously this one will go in first, so we'll get the glue. You'll pop a little bit of speck of glue onto that, and we'll literally pop that into that little hole there. You don't need to pull it along the edge of the gum because that doesn't get glued. It's literally just the peg in the tooth that goes in. And obviously, as you can see, it goes in a specific way. We'll hold that in there for a couple of minutes. I feel like a dentist. So obviously, while that's gluing in, we'll then move into tooth number 2, which is gonna be this one. And tooth number 2 goes over here. Okay, so obviously we'll see that that don't go like that. So obviously we'll move it and we'll pop that one there in just to make sure that goes in fine. And as you can see, you may need to move it around a bit just to get it the right fit. I think this one goes over here. As you can see, that goes better over there. Now, although I know it looks like I'm mucking them up, but I do know what I'm doing because they've switched them round. Okay, so I think it was that one. No, it was that one, wasn't it? So obviously, now I have seen people use their own makeup, you know, put their own teeth in and, you know, brighten the teeth up a bit. But to me, there's no need to do that. You know, you're making a model. You're not, you know, you're replicating something. I don't really understand why you would want to mod it. Me, I would only mod it if, you know, you really wanted to. As I said, I am modding the Spitfire Plane 2 with weathering, and it's your model. If you want to mod it, you can. You know, it's your model. You can do however you wish. I like to do a modded version and then like an unmodded version. But yeah, as you can see, that's going in really nice. So what we're going to do now, we're going to put the other tooth in. You said screw then. And we're not even using screws. So obviously this one will go into there like that. Now obviously there shouldn't be too much of a gap. There is a slight gap there in the teeth if you look, but it's just the way it's designed. There's nothing we can do about that. So obviously that will go into there quite nicely. And then obviously we'll put the last of the tooth into this one. When I done the first one, the harsh set version, I really enjoyed it. I thought it was great fun doing this. So obviously put that in there. Screw that around. And they have like little pins on, as you can see. And then obviously that goes in. Now again, as you can see here, there's quite a big gap there compared to the gap that's just there. But you know what? It's just how the system, how it goes in. But if you push it in, as you saw, it won't correctly in. So as I pushed it in, it sort of sealed that gap off. So that looks pretty good, as you can see. And it could be that the tooth has a little bit of excess sprue on it. So you need to file that down to seal that gap. So as you can see, that is that part there. And as you can see, if I just bring it over again, you'll see that basically that marries up with that one there. It's not too much of a gap, although this one has more of a gap than that, but I have a way of sorting that gap, and I'll show you a little bit. Well, actually I could show you now. Basically, if that was me, I'd put some like glue behind the tooth just to make it look like it's sealed, but I won't do it in this one. So we'll pop that over to one side for the minute. The next step, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this part and this part, okay? And what's gonna happen is it says basically that we're gonna match them up, and then there is a notch on one side and a line as shown. And then we're gonna screw them together. So basically, as you can see, 2 notches, goes like that, onto there. I think it goes a specific way here because, yeah, as you can see, you've got a groove here. So obviously it matches up with the groove. So obviously it matches into that little groove there. Okay, that one doesn't have it. Okay, so it is directional. Once you're happy with that, we're gonna put 2.6 screws in, which I believe are these ones here. I'll just double check. Okay, so yeah, there is a KB version in here as well, but obviously I've got that because that's 2.6, that's KB, because this is a flash head. If you look at that, that's got a rounded head, whereas this one is more of a flat flush head. So obviously that will go into there. I'll just use the tweezers just to line that up into the hole. And then obviously what that means is I can then screw that down, as you can see. And screw that right the way down. Like so, as you can see. And then we'll pop in the other KB screw now. So I'm just gonna get the head of the screwdriver again. Whoops. We'll pop that into there. We'll screw that into a position. We'll form part of the arm section. For the right arm. So we'll just pop that in there. Lovely jubbly. And there we go, guys. That is all it wants us to do in this issue. So obviously that's that section. It coming up in next Tuesday, we start to really do the stage for the right arm and first finger. So this is sort of like what we're going to be doing next Tuesday. Sorry about that. I pop that underneath. So I hope you like that video. Please remember to like and subscribe. I'll be back next Tuesday with more of the Terminator from Agora Models. Take care. Bye bye.